We have dedicated this afternoon today specifically to look at leopards. You know, earlier we had a theme about underwater and marine issues, but this time we thought we'd look at issues related to leopard. Personally, for me, leopard's my favorite big cat. It's very agile, very secretive, and I'm sure all of you know about leopards. But also, I think there's a lot of new science about leopards that we fully don't understand, and more importantly, conservation consequences of leopards that do not understand completely. So today we have three speakers, each one representing different part of the leopards. So we'll have them one by one. So first I would like to call upon the world famous Giri Kavale. Where is he? Giri, please come on. Giri does not need introduction. If anyone's been to Kabini, anyone's talks about leopard, it has to be followed by Giri. So he does not need my introduction, but I must say that exactly 12 years ago, I got my best leopard picture till date with Giri. We were driving together in BR Hills. So Giri is definitely the leopard man of India. So Giri, over to you.
Thanks, Kalyan. So my talk today is mainly going to be about photography, though I photograph other forms of wildlife. As Kalyan mentioned, today's afternoon is mainly dedicated for leopards. So all my pictures today is about on leopards. And I've selected two different landscapes today. One is the northwestern India, especially Bera, which is very close to my heart because of the landscape it provides there, and also about mostly about the southern forest, especially Kabini, Anchi, Dandeli, and places like these. And I've included two slides which I'm going to show about the African landscape. So I came to know about Bera sometime in 2006. So obviously it was not known for the right reasons, because everybody knew Bera, but also people knew that the Takur, or the head of the village there, baits leopards, and he probably takes tourists on them. So way back in 2006, 2007, I had contacted him. I told him, I'm a photographer, I wanna come, but I am not gonna come if you're gonna bait these cats. So he said, I don't know about you, and most people who come here are not photographers. They just want to see the animal, and the only way I ensure is by baiting. So that was the end of the talk. I never ventured again to his territory till, I think the first time I went there was way back in 2010. So this time he called me back, because he had, social media had grown strong, and he called me back saying, I like your work. And things have changed now, and the forest department have also placed guards so that to ensure baiting doesn't happen and stuff like that. So sometime in November 2011 was my first visit to this place. I just loved the landscape, because it's a good part of Aravallis where there are small hillocks. Any village basically around Bera has hillocks. Most of the villages are just below the hillocks, and all these hillocks have leopards. Like, I've probably visited around four or five different villages where there are hillocks around them, and every hillock like this has a leopard. And it's amazing to see, because some evenings these villagers are just plowing the land, or most of them are shepherds. They're just bringing that back their cattle, mainly the sheep, and these leopards are just sitting on the rock and looking at them. So this particular place, again, this was this image was during my very first visit to Bera. This was one early morning. One of my favorite images, because to get, I always dreamt of getting a silhouette image of a leopard against a nice rocky outcrop, because Bera is known for that. It's not just about getting a tight portrait of the leopard, but also about getting animal in its habitat. So. This was one early morning. In fact, we were waiting in the jeep. Bera is, again, it's not a forest area, with very few natural prey there. So you'll probably, the leopard natural prey is only langurs and sometimes nilgais. Other than that, it lifts a sheep almost every alternate days. So this particular place again has a temple just below the hillock, and we were waiting one early morning at around 6:15 or something. This particular animal had two cubs. So I never imagined she's going to, like, I just thought if she walks on this cliff, it's going to be a nice image. And 15 minutes from then, that's exactly what happened. The cubs had just gone below. Because I had underexposed the image, you can't see the cubs, but I managed to get this nice silhouette. So Bera is again about nice rocky outcrops, nice shapes of the rocks and stuff like that. And if you observe closely, you can just see the head of the leopard there. I intentionally shot this with a wide angle, a 70-200mm rather than a tight zoom lens, just to show the habitat. So as I mentioned, these cliffs are steep, some rocky outcrops are very steep. So these langurs are so, they were not even giving alarm calls. If you observe closely, there are three leopards, the mother and two cubs. The langur close to the leopard must be around, say, 5 to 7 feet close, and the langur is not even bothered because it knows that leopard can't come so close to it. So can anybody guess the time of the day I photographed this? Just a wild guess. So some of you know so this was 8 o'clock in the night. It was a full moon day. And the idea was to get the blue sky behind. It was pitch dark when I shot this, but what I did was I had my camera on a beanbag, sturdy beanbag, and the light on the leopard is actually from a torch. And it was this particular image, I exposed it for around 15 seconds. So why, and the torch light is only for probably less than a second or something. So the leopard is exposed for that 1 second, and I got the exposure on the sky for the remaining time. So I had to do a couple of trial and error shots for this, but I ultimately got it. I lost around 3 frames because the leopard had, like, it had moved by that time and things like that. So for this particular shot, it was cooperative and it was there. So I put a lot of thought process behind the images, not just, what is it, just show a leopard, just sitting there, your images has to be different to stand out. Otherwise, there is no point in getting the same portraits whenever you go. This was, again, as I told you, most hillocks have temples. And there was a cave just behind this temple. And we knew the leopards are there behind this particular hillock. Every day in the morning, if the leopards happens to be there in that particular hillock, they usually come, like the habit of leopards in Bera is late in the evening, they come down the hillock, go into the village to probably pick up a cattle or something. And early in morning, they come back to the cave and they rest in the caves. So that's what they do because there is no forest, it's all shrub jungle and stuff. So this particular morning, like I tried for 3 consecutive mornings to get this image. So first 2 mornings were a failure because the leopard was in some other hillock. So finally the 3rd morning, as I was about to leave that time, there are no alarm calls there because there is no spotted deer. It's only langurs, only very rarely langurs call if they are close by. So this particular temple, every day sharp 9 o'clock, a priest comes, he does his daily chores, like he washes the front part of the small temple there, and he prays and goes. So this was 8:45. This leopard came. It just went behind the temple and it just entered the cave. 9 o'clock sharp, the priest came. He did his daily chores. He went back. So as he was going back, I asked him, "Do you know there is leopard?" He says, "I know because I've been living here for years." So the leopards are very comfortable with living around people. So as I said, Bera is not a forest. This particular evening, we were just driving back to our resort, and suddenly a farmer on our right, he was yelling, and my guy with a spotlight, he just shunned the spotlight towards the field, and the farmer was actually holding a stick and chasing a leopard. So I had a 70-200mm lens, just pushed up, bump up my ISO, and I knew I'll not be able to focus the leopard. So So all I did was focus the light as the leopard started running towards the road. This probably, it's jumping from the field to the road to go back to the rock, to where it was, because he was chasing it. He was chasing because it had come to pick up one of his sheep. So this particular jump, it might be around 7 feet. It's jumped one leap. It just jumped and went across. So I was lucky to get around 8 frames because I had a fast camera, and this was one of the frames. So this is actually a camera trap image. I had no clue about camera trapping before. I just bought a Trailmaster and a couple of flashes, and I just went to Bera. So later on, when I went there, I figured out you can predict the animal paths, where it goes, but the biggest challenge was there is no soil to actually fix your cameras or flashes, so because it's all rocky terrain. So this was placed on the ground, and this was again 3-4 days of effort, and I got my first frame. This was way back in 2011 again. Again, the next year, I went back. I think December 2013, there was a supermoon, 13 or 14. There was a supermoon. So the idea behind this trip was to get a supermoon and the leopard together. So if you see my composition, I left most part of the sky to get a moon there. And I just hoped if I was lucky, a leopard might come. So this was sometime in the morning. This is a male leopard. This is shot with a 10-20 lens, and I'd placed it around 12 mm or something. So you can imagine how close the leopard is, because it's not even full in the frame. So again, very interesting in Bera. One rock is used by multiple leopards. One particular rock, I observed around 8 leopards. And I have people there who say that they've seen 11 to 12 leopards together. It's like they're living in a pride. It's not even, it's very unknown behavior of them. Probably Vidya might throw more light when she comes. So the same trap, camera trap again. This is late in the evening. This is a different male which has come there. I was unlucky, I didn't get the moon, but I got a couple of leopard images. So this is a female, again the same thing. The first image was around 3 in the afternoon. The second male, what I showed you, this one was around 11 in the night, and this female was around 11:30. So probably two different males and one female were using this particular rocks. So just two images I included from the African landscape. This was in Tanzania. Why I want to show these two images is if you don't know your subject, it's tough to sort of get good images. So this particular leopard had a kill. This is an acacia tree. There are two branches. So on the right branch, there was a kill. So we saw this leopard at around 7 in the morning. So at some point in time, I knew the light is going to be harsh, really, on the leopard. And knowing this cat, it doesn't want too much of, like, especially after it's eaten, it doesn't want to stay in sunlight for too long. So we waited for almost 3 hours. So when I actually photographed this particular image, it was 10 in the morning. So because there was too harsh a light on this particular leopard, so he finally came down this branch, jumped over to the other, and just lied down on the other because there was more cover. So this is the other one. This particular place, it's called Dutu in Tanzania. Here you can actually off-road, in the sense there are no rules, there are no set rules that you have to be on the road. This was taken from below the tree. The leopard was literally on top of me sleeping. So that's the right branch, what I was telling you. You can see the kill there. It was a small wildebeest. So this was resting, like the whole day, the leopard just slept there. So again, coming down south, the next set of images I'm going to show is from close to Bangalore, Kabini. So this was one particular morning, sometime in October. We were driving for the previous 2 days. We knew there was one courting couple of leopards, a male and female, hanging around that area. And if you understand cat behavior, when they are mating, they don't travel too long. So I just concentrated the next 4 or 5 drives just around one particular road. So it was like we used early, every morning we used to just take this road, evening we used to take this road. So the last day we were lucky. In fact, I was sitting in front, my driver was there, Arun in the audience, he was there with us. So we just drove down on this road and I just tapped to my driver and I said, leopard. So and I just took out my camera and I started shooting. So I was just, this leopard was sitting on top and I was shooting one more leopard which was just below the tree, that was the male. I didn't even know the female was on the tree. So after 1 minute my driver says, sir, you're shooting the wrong one because there's a better one on top of the tree. So after a few minutes she started coming down and that's when, this is one of my favorite images because to get a leopard in South India like this is tough. So as she was coming down and when she stopped, I observed there's a small thin white line what you see just below the black branch. It was actually, there was actually a web of a giant wood spider. So I imagined if she comes down the next shot I should be ready and get the spider in frame. This display probably it's tough for you to see, but in the laptop it's clearly visible. So it's also important to get some life in your images. Still photography, it's very tough to show action. So if you see the right paw of the leopard, it's slightly moved. That's because I deliberately reduced, like I increased my F number so that I get a fast, like a slower shutter speed. That's what the idea behind the shot was. Some days you're really lucky. This was one such afternoon in August in 2013. The previous 2 days I was tracking this courting couple. Every morning, evening I was tracking them. So as I said, they don't move too much. So this particular afternoon, in fact, we were looking at two more leopards, a mother and cub. And I told my driver, let's forget about the mother and cub because they'd just finished a kill and they'd eaten well and they're just lying down. So while the other cars were just busy with the mother and cub, so I just told my driver, let's drive on the main road. This is a highway which connects Karnataka and Kerala. So this particular courting couple were seen on the main road for 3 days. So that particular evening, we were just driving on the main road. There was a slight drizzle because it's monsoon, and I see a big traffic jam on the highway. And the traffic jam was mainly all these lorries and bikes. Because it's connect Kerala, most of these guys are on lungis and they park their bikes, lift up their lungis and they're looking at the tree. So I didn't know what it was. So when we parked there, I saw these two beautiful cats and they were least bothered. These were probably around 30 feet from the main road, but they were least bothered about people's presence there. So. Again, they were actually resting like this most of the time, and when they wanted to mate, they used to go on the other branch of this tree, and they used to mate and they used to come back. So at one particular time, this male, what you see on the right is the male, which is resting, the one standing is the female. So when the female walked towards the male, I knew she wanted to sit and there's no place there. And having known leopards, I just imagined that she's gonna jump over the male. And I had to be ready with my composition because I had a 500mm that day. I didn't have my smaller lens and it was 30 feet. So what I did was my next frame, the moment she came here, I composed my image so that I actually get her jumping. This was again shot at 8 frames a second. So I was able to get all the 8 frames when she jumped. But this is a full frame. I couldn't afford to miss this moment because I've never seen this happen any time. So what I did here, a quick thing was I composed and I focused on the leopard which was sitting. I didn't even try and focus the female because I knew I'm gonna miss it. So because it's in the same pen, I just focused on the leopard which was sitting, that's the male. And I just composed visually and I just clicked. So I got a series of around 8 frames and this is what happened. So she crossed and she sat for a while. That was not the end of it. The male came down this particular branch and climbed the other branch and she was wanting to mate again. And so she started coming down and at one moment I thought she's gonna jump. I was probably not ready. So this was the two branches in two different trees. So there is a slight shake in the image, but I still like it. It was very late in the evening, actually, and plus it was raining. So one day I was really lucky. That's probably my luckiest day in wildlife. So just a typical portrait of what you can get from Kabini. So Kabini is right now famous for this guy especially. So back in 2009, 2007, when I used to go to Kabini, sightings were not that great. We used to see probably around 3 tigers a month and probably around 10 leopards a month. So that was the thing Kabini was. But today, in peak time, if you go, that is in, say, February or March, you can probably, in one safari, I saw 6 different leopards in Kabini, just in one safari. So that's how the park has changed, probably thanks to protection from the Forest Department. So Kabini, as I was saying, is known more for this guy now, because this is the only place in India right now where a tourism zone has a black panther. So if you're lucky, I've got lucky on a few occasions, so this is one such image. Well, this was my first ever black panther sighting. This was in Dandeli Forest. So 2013-14, VMR, me and few of us were doing a project in Dandeli. Mainly, we were camera trapping. So one such evening, so I was with a guard and my wife happened to accompany me on this particular trip. So I just finished setting up my camera trap. It was around 6:15 in the evening. I remember the date, it was April 12th, because it was my first black panther sighting. So we finished putting up our camera trap and I wanted to test the flash as the sun goes down. And I heard a Malabar giant squirrel alarm call. So I knew some cat was there. And I knew that path is usually taken by a tiger because we had got a tiger on our camera trap previously. So I never imagined what it was. I didn't have a camera in hand. The only camera which was there was the camera trap. So the moment I heard the alarm call, it became strong. Next day, langur called. So then I told the guard, like, I need to get my camera from the vehicle. And my vehicle was around 1/2 kilometer away. So I quickly ran up the road, a small path actually. So took my camera and by that time the alarm calls had stopped when we came down. And there was a big clump of bamboo which had fallen down on the track. So suddenly spotted deer started calling and I saw something black jet across like through the track and I saw this black panther. This was my first black panther sighting. It was on foot, so it was special for me. So these are a few more camera trap images from Dandeli. So we could able to predict the leopard behavior because almost every week one cat used to, this particular leopard used to just go on this particular track. Again, this one is also from Dandeli. I just like the feel because the leopard is actually not looking in the camera. So after 2 years of effort, we managed to get only one black panther image from Manchi. This happened again in the month of January, sometime 2015. So I think I'll end my talk with Kalyana's
student.
I think no, this is the last one I had.
Thanks a lot, Giri.